This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. We're going to continue solving some basic proportions, and in this video, we're going to do these four problems. So here's the first one. We want to solve for x. Write our answer as a reduced fraction, a mixed number, and in decimal form. So why don't you try this on your own first? All right, so remember, when we have a proportion, a over b equals c over d, we could multiply those together, and it equals the same as if we multiply those together. So we're going to find the variable x and multiply 8. This is sometimes called cross multiplication. 8 times x is the same thing as 12 times 3. And 12 times 3 is 36. We could do that in our head. And then we're just going to solve this equation. Got rid of the fractions. Divide by 8. And reduce, because that's the first thing, writing is a reduced fraction. So let's see, how could I reduce 36 eighths? I could divide the top and bottom by 4. So that'll give me 9 halves, right, by dividing the top and bottom by 4. So there it is as a reduced fraction. But it also says to write as a mixed number. How do we do that? 9 divided by 2 is 4 with a remainder of 1. So that's 4.5. How do we write that in decimal form? Hopefully you know that 1/2 is 0.5, which is 4.5. Or you could do long division, 9 divided by 2. And get 4.5 that way. All right, so there's three ways we could write the answer here. Here's the second one. And again, try this one on your own. It's just like the last problem. All right, so we've got to find the variable. Here's where the variable is this time, down here. So I'm going to multiply it by the 4. So I have 4 times x. And then I could multiply the other two together, 5 times 15. I'll just write that out, 5 times 15. So if we simplify that, 5 times 15 is 75. And then we'll just divide both sides by 4 to solve for x. And that does not reduce. So the reduced form is just what you see, 75 fourths. Okay, but it says to also write as a mixed number. So how do you write that as a mixed number? You do 4 into 75. So we get 8. Remainder of 3. So that's going to be 18 and 3 fourths, right? Remember the remainder, you put over what you divided by. So it's 18 and 3 fourths. And how would I write that in decimal form? Well, the whole number's got to stay the same. It's going to be 18 still. And the question is, what's the decimal part? So 3 fourths, you can do long division and you're going to get 0.75. Or you could just continue right here by putting the two zeros down. Let's see, bring down the 3, you would get 0.75 that way. Or you could have just done 3 divided by 4 and got 0.75. So here is our answer written in decimal form. Okay, next problem. Solve for x. Write the answer as a reduced fraction and in decimal form rounded to the nearest hundredth. All right, so this signifies to me that it's not going to come out evenly as a decimal, so we're going to have to round. You could use a calculator or do long division, but let's start by writing it as a reduced fraction. So we find the variable x, and we multiply it by the 3. So that'll give me 3x, and then we multiply the other two numbers together, the 2 times 7. Let's do that in our head. That's 14. Divide both sides by 3. And we've already have a reduced fraction. So 14 thirds is our reduced fraction. We don't need to reduce that any further. Now it says, also write it in decimal form rounded to the nearest hundredth. Well, you can either get out a calculator and do that, or do it with long division. I'll do it with long division because they're easy enough numbers. 3 into 14, it's going to go in 4 times. And then 3 into 20 goes in 6 times. Bring down the 2. It's going to go in 6 times again. All right, so it's going to go on forever here. So I have a repeating decimal. All right, so now if I round it to the nearest hundredth, that means I want to stop 2 places after the decimal point. So what do? You know that's where you want to stop. You look at the next number. Since it's a 5 or bigger, this rounds up. So I'm going to put approximately equal. It doesn't actually equal 4.67, but we round it, so it's approximately. And I want to make sure that does not look like a time sign. 4.67 is the rounded answer to this problem. Now, if you use a calculator and you just did in your calculator 14 divided by 3, your calculator would come at 4.66666. Eventually, at the end, you'd probably see a 7, depends on your calculator. You do it the same way. Remember, you want to stop the hundredth place is 2 places after the decimal point, and you would have to round this up from 4.66 to 4.67 because this next number is 5 or bigger. All right, so how about you try this one on your own? Same thing, you want to use proportions to rewrite the equation and solve for x, write it as a reduced fraction, and then use your calculator to do long division to write your answer in decimal form, rounded to the nearest hundredth. All right, so we find our variable x and it gets multiplied by this. So we say cross multiply, it's kind of like a cross and it's diagonal, remember. So we have x times 11, which I'm going to write as 11x equals the 12 times 5, which is 60. So divide both sides by 11 and we have a reduced fraction. Now, I didn't say to write this as a mixed number, but of course you could rewrite this as a mixed number as well. So then the next thing is to do 60 divided by 11. I'm going to do that in my calculator, but it's not that hard to do long division. These aren't huge numbers, but it's going to be approximate here. So in the calculator, I've got 5.45 rounded. So in the calculator, you'll do 60 divided by 11 and see 5.45, 45, 45, on and on and on. And this time when I round, since this next number is smaller than 5, we keep it to 5.45. We don't round up. And so there we are. So we've done 4 problems. If you want to see some problems where there's decimals in the fractions, you want to look at the next video. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.